Hello everyone, myself K.R. Biradar, Assistant Professor, Department of ENTC, WIT Solapur. Today I am going to deal a topic called Discrete Fourier Transform. Let us start with the learning outcomes first. At the end of this session, students will be able to find the discrete time Fourier transform of the sequence, compare different methods of finding the DFT. These are the some of the contents. Start with the definition of DFT, different methods of finding DFT, matrix method, first one, DFT using FFT, and lastly, references. Recall once the convincing method of finding the DFT and think for a moment whether it goes suitable for conventional method or using two other methods mentioned earlier. Using conventional method definitely takes more number of steps and even it lengthier and it takes more time to find the DFT using. About mentioned using matrix method and using FFT, it is required very less time to compute the DFT of the sequence. So this is the definition of DFT. Discrete Fourier transform for an endpoint sequence is defined as x of k is equal to summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n e raised to minus j 2 pi k n divided by capital N. So this is also written in terms of Twiddle factor, x of k is equal to summation n equal to 0 to n minus 1 x of n w n raised to n k, where w n is the Twiddle factor, which is equal to e raised to minus j 2 pi divided by capital N, where k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 up to n minus 1. Different methods of finding the DFT are conventional method, already I mentioned, but other than this, there are two methods to find the DFT, that is DFT using matrix method and DFT using fast Fourier transform algorithm, also called the DFT using FFT. So these two methods I'll discuss by taking one example here. Okay, the example shown here is find the DFT of the sequence x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Let us take this example x of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. We need to find the DFT for this sequence using first method, that is using matrix method. So if you want to find the DFT using matrix method, we need to form the matrix bar given value of n, that is here n is equal to 4. How you are going to form the matrix is, this is omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 1, omega 4 raised to 2. Since here n is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3, here k is equal to 0, 1, 2 and 3. Okay. Now we know that is a Twiddle factor omega n raised to n k. We keep on substituting the value of n and k. So in the first row k is equal to 0, all that is nothing but a factors is going to becomes equal to 0, that is omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 0, this is also omega 4 raised to 0, this is omega 4 raised to 0. Similarly, in the column also you are going to get omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 0. Since n is equal to 0, you are going to get, that is omega all zeros. Here omega 4 raised to n k is there, n value is 1, k is also 1, this is also 1. Omega 4 raised to, here n value is 2, k value is 1, that is 2 into 1 is 2. Similarly, this is omega 4 raised to 3. This all similarly, omega 4 raised to 2, omega 4 raised to 4, omega 4 raised to 6. This is omega 4 raised to 3, omega 4 raised to 6, omega 4 raised to 9. Sometimes this is also called omega r w. Now we are going to find the values of w here. To find that one, we need to draw a circle chop up with equally 4 points. Usual, this is a value is 1, this value is minus 1, this is j, this is minus j. Now this assume that omega 4 raised to this is 0, this is omega 4 raised to 1, this is omega 4 raised to 2, this is omega 4 raised to 3. Okay, now if I want to write these values here, omega 4 raised to 0 all that is equal to 1, this is 1, this is also 1, 1, this side 1, 1, 1. Similarly, omega 4 raised to 1 value is minus j, omega 4 raised to 2 is minus 1, omega 4 raised to 3 value is j. Similarly, omega 4 raised to 2 value, 2 is minus 1, this is omega 4 raised to 4. So, omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 1, omega 4 raised to 2, omega 4 raised to 3, this is omega 4 raised to 5 again, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. This still continue. Okay. Now, omega 4 raised to 0 is already 3 is j, 4 is now 1, omega 4 raised to 6, this is 4, 5, 6. Is minus 1. Similarly, omega 4 raised to 3 is, what is the value? Omega 4 raised to 3 j. What about 6? This is 4, 5, 6 is minus 1. Similarly, omega 4, 9. 9 is again minus j. This is a matrix how we are going to form. So, after finding this matrix, we need to write this matrix as usual. This is 1, 1, 1, 1. This side all column become 1. And this is minus j. This is also minus j. This is j. This is j. Minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1. This is 1. Okay. Now we need to remember like this. So, what the problem sequence he has given? Sequence 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 1, 2, 3, and 4. Multiply, this is 4 by 4 matrix, this is 4 by 1 matrix. So, the inner dimensions are same, so that you can multiply these two matrices. Now, this 1 will be all, that is row elements will be multiplied with the column. Similarly, second row element will be multiplied with second column, and third row element will be multiplied with the column. So, now this becomes 1 plus 2, that's 1 into 1 is 1, 1 into 2 is 2, 1 into 3 plus 3 plus 1 into 4 is equal to, this is total 10. Similarly, second row will be multiplied with the column, and 1 minus 2j minus 3 plus 4j is equal to minus 2 plus 2j. Similarly, 1 minus 2, this is plus 3 minus 4 is equal to 4 plus 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 plus 4 minus 6 is minus 2. Similarly, 1 plus 2j minus 3 minus 4j is equal to minus 2 minus 2j. This is a final answer to find. This is the sequence for the given sequence 1, 2, 3, 4. DFT is x of k is equal to 10 minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 minus 2 minus 2j. So, similarly, using second method is using FFT, that is DFT using FFT. So, in this diagram method, we need to draw the draw the butterfly structure for the given input, four inputs. This is x of 0, x of 2, x of 1, x of 3. So what is this is 1, this is 3, this is 2, this is 4. Draw the butterfly structures here using DIT FFT algorithm. Okay, now this will be minus 1, minus 1, this is minus 1, minus 1. The output will be x0, x1, x2 and x3. Here omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 0. This is omega 4 raised to 0, omega 4 raised to 1. For the given input, here 1, this is 3, okay. So 1 comes here and 3 will be multiplied with omega 4 raised to 0, that is 1. 3 will be multiplied with 1, it's 3 only, it comes here. 3 plus 1, which is equal to 4. Similarly, 1 comes from here, okay. So 3 comes and 3 will be multiplied with 1, 3, multiplied with minus 1, again minus 3. So 1 minus 3 is equal to minus 2. Similarly, in this case, 2 comes here, okay. So this 4 will be multiplied with omega 4 raised to 0 is 1. 4 will be multiplied with 1, again 4 comes here. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Similarly, 2 comes here, 2, and 4 will be multiplied with minus 4. 2 minus 4 is minus 2. So at the output of the second stage, so this 4 comes here and that is 4 and 6 will be multiplied with 0, omega 4 raised to 0 is 1, 6 plus 4 equal to 10. So you are getting same answer as the previous case. This is minus 2. Similarly, this minus 2 comes will be multiplied with omega 4 raised to 1 is minus j, that is 2 minus 2 multiplied by minus j is plus 2j, minus 2 plus 2j. Similarly, 4 comes from this one, okay, 4 comes here and 6 will be multiplied with minus 1, minus 6, minus 6 is equal to minus 2. Similarly, this comes minus 2, minus 2, this is minus 2 minus j plus 2j and minus multiplied with minus 1 minus 2j. This is the answer. So x of k is equal to, answer will be 10 minus 2 plus 2j minus 2 minus 2 minus 2j. This is the final. So the same as the previous. So but using these two methods, we can find the DFT very fast and accurate, whereas the conventional method requires very large time and more computational steps. This is the answer. These are references I referred. Thank you.